Hi there. Are you looking for ways to stop making mistakes, to start getting things right more often? I have an answer for you that might surprise you. Hi there. Welcome to the Productivity Test Kitchen. I'm Josh, and we're here in the kitchen, my kitchen, and I'm here with my co-host.
It's the Mandalorian.
Are you my new co-host?
I guess.
Cool. We're talking about avoiding mistakes. And now we all know that we're gonna make mistakes.
I make mistakes, you make mistakes.
So how much can be avoided? There was a book called The Checklist Manifesto by Atul Gawande in which he shares that checklists are actually the key to success, even for the most experienced people in the highest level fields. Many of us know the story of the Miracle on the Hudson, which is a story that Atul Gawande refers to in this book. If you don't know that story, it was an incredibly harrowing experience where a pilot was taking off over the Hudson Bay. The plane, just after going into the air, hit a flock of birds. The plane was going down, and this pilot had decisions to make. He was told, you need to find a place to emergency land this plane, and he landed the plane in the Hudson Bay, and not a single person was lost. Everybody survived. This man was hailed as a hero for his flight expertise, and what did he say in these interviews in response to his heroism? He said, I worked with my team, I followed procedure, I followed the checklist. The real heroic thing that he did was have the coolness of head to look down at his,
I don't know if it was a paper or a book or a digital application,
but to look down at his checklist and go step by step by step, because a checklist, in the case of aviation, in the case of so many different fields, represents the accumulation of knowledge of years and years of people packed into a single document that can be referenced and pulled back to the forefront in a moment when steps would be missed and things would be forgotten. This pilot credited a checklist and procedure with saving the lives of people that day. As much as we want to see things as the achievement of an individual, of a talented individual for their skill and their ability, more often the truth is the most talented, successful people have the humility to admit their own fallibility and follow a checklist. Atul Gawande, the author, is in the field of surgery. He's a physician and a surgeon. Oh, hi Boda, thank you. He recounts his experience of trying to work checklists into the medical profession, and actually there was a lot of pushback from talented surgeons who did not want the humiliation of following a checklist when they were assured that they knew their craft well enough not to need a checklist. Atul Gawande was actually a part of a lot of research that discovered just the sheer amount of mistakes made in surgery that have caused injury or even death. What they applied was putting checklists into the operating room in order to save lives, and it did. Even for Atul Gawande himself, he admitted he was embarrassed to follow a checklist personally, even though he believed in it. He was also a very proud surgeon who was very accomplished at his craft. Yet, in order to follow through on the point he was making, he also followed a checklist. And sure enough, he discovered a moment where, when following the checklist, they were told to check to see if there was a blood bank stored next to the patient during surgery. They had never used that piece of equipment before, but it was standard procedure to ensure that it was prepared. It turned out it was not prepared. Thanks to the checklist, they filled it and ensured it was standing by purely for the sake of following the checklist and ensuring they were following procedure. And in that particular instance, something horrible happened. A mistake was made in surgery by Atul Gawande himself, and the life of the patient was saved because there was a blood bank standing by, and it would not have been there if he hadn't followed the checklist. And this drove the point home to him that in order to get things right, the first thing we must do is admit our human fallibility, admit how often we get things wrong, not because we're bad, not because we're not talented, not because we don't know our stuff, but because the human brain is fallible and human mistakes happen, especially when there is so much information like there is in our world today. Now, where are there high stakes in your life? You may not be an airline pilot or a surgeon, but we all have things that are important to us and things that we get wrong, things that we forget. Would it be worth trying to create a checklist? I will tell you that I personally have implemented this in my life entirely. Everything from dinner with my family to putting my kids to bed, I put together a checklist. And some people think that's silly, but for me, these things are important. These things matter to me. The stakes are high. Making sure that I'm feeding my kids things that are good for them. I'm keeping my kitchen clean. I'm putting my kids to bed and I'm reading to them and I'm doing all the things that I personally value, but that I might forget in the heat of a moment. And I use a checklist because I'm fallible, because I don't get things right, because I forget things. But by admitting my own fallibility and following a checklist, I find,
not all the time, but often,
I can get it right. And I can set intentions and follow through on things that in the past I would have forgotten about. And so for me, it's worth it. Checklists are worth it. Checklists are powerful. I encourage you, if you want to know more, check out Atul Gawande's book, The Checklist Manifesto. It is truly life-changing for me. I think it can be for you, and I hope that's a blessing to you. Now, if you've enjoyed this, please check out our whole series about books for inspiration in the new year. People who have been a blessing to us, who have helped us get more control over our lives, become more productive, become more intentional, and we think can help you too. So click the link right up there. I think Baby Yoda is making it float with the Force. And please subscribe to the Productivity Test Kitchen. Best of all, leave us a comment down below. Tell us,
have you ever used a checklist? Would you ever use a checklist?
Is there something that you're struggling to get right that you think you might benefit from? We'd love to hear from you. We'd love to talk with you. We'll see you next time. You took behind the scenes video of me.
Yes!
That's super cool.
To you.
Thanks, bud.